a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. Make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. I am a child.
I'm Miss Jackie at Hillside Assembly, and I would like to talk to you today about hope. And again, here's my good friend Hope with us. We're going to talk about the first letter in her name, H, for hope is honor. Today I'd like to welcome everybody back, and hey, hi to my new friends. So right now we're going to take a moment to pray. All right, bow your heads. Everybody ready? Whoop, there's a couple of you not ready. Here we go. All right. Dear God, thank you for bringing us all together here and helping us have an amazing program for our friends. Help us remember that your love is unconditional and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Now I'd like to welcome up my friend, Miss Becca, and she has a Bible verse for you today.
Our Bible verse for today is found in Isaiah 40, verse 8. And it says, "The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our God endures forever." And what that means is that the flowers might die, and the grass might die, but the word of God will go on and on forever and ever. And what God has promised in his word will go on and on.
Hey, thanks, Miss Becca, for helping us out with that Bible verse. And I want to talk a little bit about that. Now, she talked about grass withering. You know, in the fall when the grass kind of dies and it's almost time for school again? Remember, flowers, grass, they wither away, and they come back another season. But God's season is always and here with us forever. Now, I want to show you something. I bet you some of you have this at home. Hey, Hope. Oh, you don't wear jeans. These are mine. So, on my jeans, you can see where it's darker blue, lighter, and then darker again. These faded. God's love never fades for us. He's always there for us. Just keep that in mind, and whenever you're having a bad day or need some help with something, God is always there for you.
Thank you.
Bible verse for today is from Deuteronomy 6, 5. It says, love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your strength.
God gave us rules to know how we should treat others and respect the world he created. We can find God's law in the Bible.
Rules? Law? Doesn't that sound kinda bossy?
Actually, he gave us his law because he loves us so much. God's law teaches us how to love God and love others. For example, God knows life is better when we don't do evil things, like lie or hurt each other. There's a story in the Bible about a leader named Moses. God wanted his people to know how to live, so he gave Moses the Ten Commandments to remind us what is right. We just have to obey.
There's just one problem. No one, and I mean no one, can obey the law all the time. We all make mistakes. When we compare our list of mistakes to God's law, it shows us how sinful and selfish we are.
But what if the list of our sins was erased, torn up and forgotten, every mistake forgiven?
Would God really do that?
He already did. God saw the mess we were in and sent us a free gift to fix it. That's why God sent Jesus to earth, to make things right again and forgive our sins.
When Jesus died on the cross and came back to life, that fixed our broken relationship with God. He took the punishment for all of our sins.
God gave us grace for our mistakes. All we have to do is have the faith to believe it.
Is God's grace free for everyone?
It doesn't matter who you are or what you've done. You can't earn God's grace by working harder, and you don't deserve it just because you look a certain way. Even though we don't deserve it, God's grace is free because Jesus already paid the price.
Wait, if God's grace forgives us for everything we do wrong, then we can throw out the law and do whatever we want.
No, we shouldn't do that. Faith in Jesus and God's law go hand in hand. The law shows us we are sinners who need Jesus, and Jesus helps us obey the law. We need God's grace and truth to live life the right way. God created your life to be a beautiful adventure. He loves you so much that he gave you two things to help you live life to the fullest, Jesus and his law.
When you put your faith in Jesus, you are forgiven. When you follow God's law, you are free.
Hi guys, welcome back to Kids Connect. I'm Miss Felicia. I'm so glad you could join us today. Today I'm going to talk about something that I think all of us have seen in our community. So much has happened since the last time I got to see you guys in person, and I just wanted to get a recap of what's been going on. So much has happened, right? Schools closed, restaurants closed, we couldn't go see our grandparents, parks even closed. I couldn't take Tommy to go play on the swing sets. Parents couldn't go to work, and toilet paper was nowhere to be found. I know something else happened, though, and you might have seen this, too. Around town and all over the nation, something really cool happened. People put paper hearts in all of their windows. Ms. Jackie talked about this last week, and if you haven't seen the video, go ahead and go see it. This is something you can do at home. And here's the thing about those paper hearts. We put them up. We even did it, Tommy and I did it at home too, with sidewalk chalk all over the place. I'll see if I can post the link for you to see it. But here's the thing about all those paper hearts. As time goes on, the sun comes out, and all of those paper parts that were really bright and colorful and offered a symbol of hope to everyone around us, they fade. They get all washed out, and the colors, you can't see them very well. And what once was something really bold and beautiful and a symbol of hope fades over time. That doesn't happen with the Word of God. God says that he will be there for us no matter what. His love is unconditional, and it's never going to fade. Whether you're little, no bigger than this, or if you're taller, then hope. He is always going to be there for us. Now I want you to listen to this. In Psalms 62:5, yes, my soul, find rest in God. My hope comes from him. He is the only source of hope in our community or around the world that never fades. So go ahead, put those hearts up in your windows. Offer that hope to your neighbors. I want you to really focus on Sunday where you can see those paper hearts. It'll be like a little treasure hunt. Tell me what you think in the comments below. But here's the thing. Over time, all of those bright, beautiful, colored hearts, they fade over time. And people take them down and they disappear from all the windows. God will never disappear on you. His love is unconditional, and like a father, he is always there for us. You guys, I want you to really think about that, and I'll see you next week.
Hey guys, I want you to keep an eye out on Sunday at 2 o'clock when you come to the drive-in service. Guess what? We're gonna decorate the windows with some hearts. Those paper hearts that might fade, but God's love never does. And another thing we need to keep in mind is our honoring God. We can honor God by reading the Bible, listening to our parents, helping someone out when God gives us a little nudge to do so. There's been times that God has nudged me in some pretty big ways. And you know what? If you listen to God and do what God wants, it's going to make life a lot better for you and everyone around you. My little friend Tommy needs life to be a little bit better right now, so that's okay. He's happy now. So here we go. So make sure you honor your parents and honor your parents and God. Remember, if you haven't done a window yet, go for it. Make one up. It's a ton of fun. I have a friend of mine, Pastor Eric, who's going to talk to us about Father's Day today. And that's a good way to lead into honoring our parents.
Hi, guys. Thanks for joining us for Kids Connect. I hope you had a great time today with Miss Jackie and all of our special guests. I'm here with Hope, and we're getting ready for Sunday drive-in church. I hope you'll be there this Sunday at 2 p.m. Do you know that this Sunday is a very special day? That's right. Can you guess what holiday it is this Sunday? No, it's not Christmas. No, it's not Thanksgiving. No, it's not quite the 4th of July just yet. It's Father's Day. And you know a great way to honor your dad this Sunday? You could do a lot of really great things. You could make him breakfast, or you could say, hey, let's go for a drive after church. Maybe get some ice cream. Or you could even wash your dad's car. I bet he'd love that. So I hope you'll honor God by honoring your dad this Sunday for Father's Day. Well, Hope and I got a lot to do. We'll see you next week for Kids Connect.